Connection established.
It's Realtor Roundtable, available on iTunes, Stitcher, and anywhere on PhillipeConsulting.com. A place real estate professionals come to better their business. Here to help you better your real estate business. What more do you want? Listen, subscribe, and share. Now, let's get to it.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to this week's Real Estate Roundtable. My name is Darren Phillippe, CEO of Keller Williams, the Marketplace here in Vegas, and also creator of the Real Estate Tech Academy, found at realestatetechacademy.com. And I wanted to thank you so much for listening to this podcast. Thanks for taking the time to download it and taking just a few minutes of your day to listen to it. And I wanted to thank you for, implementing the things that you guys have been doing. I've gotten some great feedback, like always. And also, you guys are doing a fantastic job of sharing those ideas that you've that have been helpful with me, and that's very cool, very very nice of you. It makes me energized and excited about what's going on in real estate right now, and knowing that when I share things with you guys, that I'm actually making a difference. It's super super cool to be able to hear about some of these successes and knowing that I'm impacting you guys that are across the country and, in fact, across the world. I've got some amazing downloads from crazy parts of the world, and it's just amazing that people in Qatar would actually listen to me. I'm huge in Qatar, everybody. Anyway, I kind of wanted to talk a little bit today about focus. I wrestled in college, and focus in sports is kind of a big thing. Being able to focus on some key things to help you increase your production, or in wrestling, it's be able to focus on some of the tasks that you're doing to find that success. So when it comes to focus to you, and when I say focus, what does that mean? What is focus in your real estate business? What does that mean to you? What are you focused on right now? What are the things that you focus on every single day? Are you focused on some good things, like goals? Are you focused on some great activities that help drive your business? Are you focused on your kids and helping them succeed? Are you focusing on being a great parent? Are you focused on being a great sibling or a great family member or something like that? Are you focused on being a great person in the community or a great coach? Are you focused on being a great example? What are some of the things that you're focusing on in your life? Or are you focused on the chaos that's going on? Are you focused on some of the crappy stuff that's going on that, man, I woke up today and, geez, things have just gone wrong. All of my clients that I'm working with, it's just fallen apart. Nobody can get a loan these days. Getting a loan is impossible. Getting any of my clients financed just doesn't happen. Man, can anybody at the bank ever be competent? What are those things that you are surrounding yourself with and focusing on? Think about that in your business. There's a coaching course here at Keller Williams called Bold. And if you've listened a few episodes back, Chris McNamara, he's a Bold coach. On the podcast that I interviewed him on, he spoke about video and how to use video. Anyway, he's a Bold coach. And one of the things that they talk about in Bold is what you focus on expands. So are you focusing on good, positive things that are going to get you to where you want to go? Or are you focusing on chaos and the bad things and the negative things that are going on in your life and in your business? I think focus is a big deal, and I think as we go through our day and interact with people and do our career and do our family and do just live our life, that focus, what we focus on, really does expand. If we focus on things that suck, man, everything sucks. If we focus on some of the great things, man, everything's great. You know, I was sitting there thinking a little bit about, I grew up up in Washington State, and my dad was a hunter safety course guy. He taught classes on how to use guns safely. And of course, I was a Boy Scout, but I was the worst Boy Scout in the world. I was in Scouts my whole youth, and the best I ever did was Tenderfoot, which, by the way, is like lame. Anyway, so one of the things we do a lot in growing up, up in Washington, I kind of lived in the country a little bit, and my dad was the hunter safety course guy. He would help kind of sight guns up. So, like, for instance, when you get a gun and it has the sight, there's the scope, and you have to do certain things in the scope and also with the sight, where they have those two little fork prongs, and you have that red ball at the end of your barrel, and you need to sight that in. You sight a gun in, either on a scope or on the sight itself, to make it so when you're shooting, it actually goes right where it's supposed to go. So when you sight your gun in, and you have your target a long ways away, a couple hundred yards away or something like that, and you try to shoot that target, sometimes it's really difficult to hit that target because you have to count on, you know, the wind blowing and, you know, all those kind of variables, how big your gun is and all that kind of stuff. So sometimes it's difficult to be able to hit that target from a long ways away. So what you might need to do is, man, maybe your sighting is all jacked up. And so you bring a target in a little bit closer and see if it's the sighting. And so what you try to do is you bring it in closer, and maybe you could hit it at 50 yards or 25 yards or whatever that is. It's been a long time since I've done this. So anyway, that being said, you're able to go ahead and get that sighting in, so when the target is closer, you can hit it. Now, what's interesting is this. Sometimes when you're shooting at a target that's close, and you're not quite hitting it right on the bullseye, but you're getting nearby, when that target is moved farther away, you'll completely miss the target. But you're shooting the same way, and you're shooting the same area. So let me go back a little bit. Why does that happen? Well, what happens is, just because you were just a couple of inches off when it was short distance, when it gets a long ways away or farther distances, that couple of inches turns into a couple of feet. So why am I even bringing this up? A lot of times when you have your activities and you're focusing on reaching your short goals, and if your short goals are to make maybe 20 contacts in a day or 10 contacts in a day, and by the end of the day, you realize that you made 7 or 8 contacts, you're like, oh, that's pretty good. I came close to hitting my target. As time goes on and you continue to shoot at that target at a short distance, when we really look at the distance of a long-term target or long-time goal, you consistently hitting 7 contacts rather than the 10 contacts that you need to be able to hit the bullseye or hit the target, you're now 2 feet off. Rather than you making $100,000, you're making $60,000. And so what happens is this. When we focus on things and we're okay with not being exact or not being right on target, in the long run, when we're shooting at long distances, we may not hit the target. So I think focus is really a key to being able to reach our goals. So what I wanted to do is share with you 5 ways to help you with your focus. These are 5 ways that Gary Keller has shared with us in the Millionaire Real Estate Agent book. 5 ways that we can help us make sure that we keep focused. And the first one is to create a personal plan and make sure that the implementation process is your focus. So the key is this. Focusing on what matters most, which is truly not creating just a great plan, but focusing on the actions, the implementation, or following through on that plan, that's the key. So create an awesome plan and then focus on the implementation of that plan. And one of those key things is really knowing what that plan is. Number 2, time block to get your focus. If those implementation tasks or those things that you need to get done, they're not just a to-do list, but a must-do list, it's important to make sure that you time block those things. So do not let anything else get in the way of making that happen. You've got to make sure that you get that task done. You stay focused on that task. And you make sure that you time block a certain, that specific time to accomplish that goal. All right? Number three, get accountability to keep your focus. Because what happens is as time goes on, you get an awesome idea. Man, I'm going to accomplish this. I'm going to get this done. I'm going to reach this goal or whatever. Right? We feel like that a lot of times in January. Or we feel like that a lot of times when we change companies or change careers or whatever. Man, I'm excited. This is awesome. And then what happens is life sets in. Challenges come along. And our excitement becomes normal. And it turns into just a regular day. And our attention starts to drift. And it's not that big of a deal anymore. It's not that important for us anymore. And so for you to have somebody that's there to help you stay accountable and make sure that you're accomplishing the things that need to be done to help you stay focused on your long-term target and your short-term target. Very, very important is make sure you have that. So where can you get that? Well, you can use coaching as a process. You could use a process at Keller Williams. They have a thing called a 401. It's just a way, basically a game plan that breaks down your annual goals, your monthly goals, your weekly goals, and even your daily goals. And following that sort of thing. And then have an accountability partner. That's another great way for you to be able to help you with that focus. But find that thing that's going to help you be accountable to keep your focus. Fourth thing. Make sure your environment supports your focus. So there's two different areas. I mean, if you're trying to accomplish things, what are the things that really create your environment? The physical environment and the people that are in that environment. So let's talk a little bit about that physical. Where do you do your business? Where's your home office? Or do you have an office in your real estate office? Is it in the bullpen? Is it quiet? Is it loud? Is it exciting? Is it whatever that is, do you have proper lighting? Do you have the proper tools? Do you have the proper equipment? What does your office look like? Where is your environment? What's the actual physical environment that's around you? If you're not in an environment that's going to be uplifting, you're shooting yourself in the foot. And then the same thing with people. Man, I'll tell you, for you to be able to make sure that you stay focused, you need to surround yourself with people that are uplifting. See, the deal is this. Your environment either is going to help you or it's going to hinder you. So are the people around you, the people that you are doing business with, you're in business with, and the people that are outside of your business, if those people are uplifting, that's helping you with your focus. But if you have people that are surrounding you, that are in your environment, that are negative, that are distracting, that are pulling you away from your focus, it's sure difficult to be able to get your focus done. You better believe it's pretty difficult to keep your focus. Now, there's a movie. And I can't remember the movie. So this, I don't even know why I'm bringing it up because, by the way, I'm not going to come to the conclusion. I was going to go and ask my wife what movie we watched, but I was too lazy and I didn't want to get up off the couch. But that being said, there's a movie that I remember watching. And you guys, if you guys can remember, shoot me an email, send me a message or whatever. But there was a movie that I remember watching. It was a sports movie or whatever, that the guy would, when he was going to do that sports activity, he would say something like, focus. And all the chaos that was going on in his life and all the chaos that was going on in the baseball field would all of a sudden go, and it would be silent and he wouldn't hear anything. And that's a pretty amazing talent. And some people have that ability. But the question is this, is your environment and the people around it, is that providing you support to be able to focus like that? Or are you having things pulled away? So anyway, and it's a recent movie that I just watched, but whatever. All right. And so, and the last one, the fifth one is to keep your energy maintained in your focus. How do you have that energy to be focused? Because I'll tell you, to be focused, it's kind of exhausting. And I'm not really the guy to speak to on this one because some of the things that we need to do, We need to go to bed early. We need to wake up early, get our sleep. We need to treat our body right. We need to eat properly. We need to exercise. Some of those things that we do to help us stay healthy is what will help us stay focused. And as you can tell, that I'm not probably the slimmest dude in the world. But dang it, I sure love doing this podcast. So hopefully you guys will get over this. So anyway, so those are the five things to help you with your, to keep your focus and get you focused. Number one, create a personal plan and make sure that the process is where you focus on. Number two, time block to get your focus. Number three, get accountability to keep your focus. Number four, make sure your environment supports your focus. And number five, keep your energy to maintain your focus. That's it, guys. Focus. I think it's really the big difference between different levels of production. The ones that are able to focus at a high level, the ones that are able to focus on the right things, the ones that are able to focus on those great positive things, and if we focus on those positive things, it will expand. If you're constantly saying to yourself and in creating an environment of, I am great at taking listings, I'm great listing agent, and people around you are supportive of that, and your calendar allows you to do the lead generation to create those listing appointments, and you've got an accountability coach or somebody that's helping you stay accountable to the things that you say you're going to do to get those listings appointments. All of those things are what's going to help you achieve your ultimate goal. And that's just been on my mind for a while. Last few days, I've been thinking about focus and having a laser focus. So, all right. Well, thanks for listening, guys. I really do appreciate it. It's been fantastic. It's been an awesome week for me. I can't tell you how excited I am to have launched my new website, realestatetechacademy.com. And what I'd like you guys to do is do me a favor. A lot of you guys, you listen to a podcast, you're relatively technically sound, and so you're pretty good at using technology. Well, I created Real Estate Tech Academy, not really for those guys who really know what's going on. What happens is this. A lot of real estate agents were coming to me and saying, Darren, I need help on my technology. How do you use social media? How do you use your database? How do you use all these different tools that I feel like I need to know how to do? And so I thought this would be a great resource. So I created my first module, which was the social media for real estate module. It allows people to learn how to use social media at a high level, step by step. So you guys who are listening probably get it. Okay, I've had some people visit from across the country, and so I know it's my podcast because you guys went there before it was even launched. So what I'd like you to do is do me a favor. If you want to help me out and you want to continue saying, hey, Darren, I like listening to your podcast. I subscribe all the time. I've told people about the podcast, but some people just don't get the podcast. Do me a favor. I want in every single market center, every single office real estate company across the country, there's always people that just don't get technology. Do me a favor. Go up to somebody. Go up to a few people that are in your office and say, hey, I just want to let you know something. I listened to this podcast. This guy created an awesome website that will help you understand your social media. And then tell them the website. Open it up for them. Say, go to this website, realestatetechacademy.com. Tell them to go there. Tell them to sign up for the newsletter, get some tips. Tell them to watch a couple of videos. And geez, ask them to pay. It's $10. $10 to have over nearly 15 hours worth of videos. That's step-by-step video tutorials. Now, again, you guys get it. You guys know how to work social media, or my guess is some of you guys do. But do me a favor. Turn to the guys that are in your office and say, hey, check this out. This guy, he's created this awesome, awesome tool. So anyway, thank you for listening, guys. Thank you very much for your follow-through. You guys have been fantastic. Continue to listen to my podcast. I've got some great episodes coming up, some really exciting ones that I'm excited to share, some really cool interviews and stuff like that. So thanks for listening, guys. Now go out and take action today.
Thank you for listening to Realtor Roundtable. You can follow Darren on Twitter at dphilippi and on Google Plus at Darren Philippi. Listen, subscribe, and share.